Good afternoon. Well, we just had a meeting with the Secretary General, Antonio Guterres. Very useful, helpful meeting. We spoke about a diversity of issues, and especially about the situation in Venezuela, which has been censored in many ways by the media all over the world. Venezuela, after the election of the National Constituency Assembly, is in peace. The opposition was defeated by the democracy, by the votes of the people. More than 8 million Venezuelans elected the National Constituent Assembly that is working with the constituted powers, with the executive, with the parliament, with the electoral power, with the citizen power in Venezuela. We spoke also about the threats that the United States, its president, we spoke about these threats in the House, in the headquarters of the international law, in the headquarters of the peace for the world, and how absurd, hostile are the military or the use, the threat of the use of the force against a peaceful nation as Venezuela, in a peaceful region as Latin American and the Caribbean. We impose no threat to the world. And of course, the sanctions that, the supposed sanctions that today the United States government with an executive order have also announced.
Good afternoon. It's a strong message for the people of Venezuela, and it's a strong message to Maduro. We are not going to tolerate the dictatorship he's trying to create, and we're not going to respect the sham assembly. And so at this point, we felt like because we're not seeing any progress towards lifting up the Venezuelan people, and we see more of the power grab that Maduro is trying to do, the sanctions were another option to send him a message. We don't agree with anything that Maduro is doing, but we've said that for months. And what we've said is the way he's treating his people, the way he's trying to create a dictatorship, the sham assembly that we have is not anything that the U.S. can support. So we have had no choice but to turn around and do the sanctions to get their attention. We hope that they will see the error of their ways. We hope that they will go back to a democracy, which is what we hope for Venezuela. I think that we're trying to see exactly where we go. You know, what we wanted initially was to rely on the OAS to deal with this, but obviously they weren't able to, and then Venezuela left the OAS. And then we tried to bring up an Emergency Security Council meeting because we were very concerned, and you know, we had some reactions from the Security Council. They didn't think this was about peace and security. I think we can all attest to the fact that it is about peace and security. We've done the sanctions, and now we'll see if there's anything else in the UN that we need to do. But this is all moving forward. All right, thank you all very much. Appreciate it.